Can you know the first recombinant DNA, artificially constructed one? So the first recombinant DNA, artificially constructed one, that is belongs to Salmonella type Mearum. Here the desired gene is inserted into the Salmonella DNA. The desired gene is antibiotic resistant gene. Antibiotic resistant gene is incorporated into the DNA of Salmonella type Mearum, and also it get altered as a recombinant Salmonella which against work for antibiotics. Okay, so this is the first developed RDNA, first developed RDNA. And we are discussing about the tools of the RDNA. In order to that, first we already discussed the restriction enzymes. Then you are coming to the cloning vectors. Cloning vectors are genetic carriers. So you foreign DNA, so the desired characters are present. So the desired character consisting DNA can be incorporated or integrated into the host DNA. So it is carried by the vehicles. Okay, so the vehicles are called as a vectors. So also called as gene vectors, genetic vectors, cloning vectors. So many cloning vectors are used. Generally the cloning vectors are originated from the prokaryotic cells. So they are plasmids. Commonly using genetic vectors are plasmids, bacteriophages, cosmids. So the cosmids are having the cos sites of the phage. So bacteriophages, so these bacteriophages also used as cloning vectors. Bacterial artificial chromosomes, okay, so yeast artificial chromosomes also used as cloning vectors. But ideal cloning vectors are plasmids. So when you see plasmids and cosmids, so plasmids are again two types, natural plasmids, derived plasmids. Natural plasmids means directly isolated from the bacterium source. Or artificial or derived plasmids means the part of the plasmid is taken from the one bacterium and combination with the part of the DNA or part of the plasmid with the another bacterium. So like hybrid plasmids or derived plasmids also used in RDNA technology. Here the cosmids. Cosmids means it is a combination, it is a hybrid vector, it is a combination of cos sites. The cos sites are taken from the phages. But here the mid phages, it means the half of the part or few of the part of the vector is taken from the plasmid. So but the cos sites are taken from the phages. So by combination these two, the cosmids are produced. So the cosmids also used in RDNA technology as genetic vectors. Okay, so when you come to the plasmids, plasmid is nothing but of double stranded DNA which is extra nuclear chromosome, double stranded circular DNA, closed DNA in the bacterium. So you see the bacterial cell, in the bacterial cell the xenophore is present. Along with the xenophore, the plasmid extra nuclear chromosome is present. So the number of plasmids are bacterium to bacterium, species to species, they are differentiated. So you see here two types of the plasmids can found according to their numbering. So single copy number of plasmids, multiple copy number of plasmids. Single copy of plasmids means within single bacterium only one plasmid is present, that is single copy number, single copy of plasmid. Okay, so the plasmid number also changed according to the favorable condition. In adverse condition, the number of plasmids are increased. It means, so for example, one disease is caused, it means Salmonella causing the disease. While disease condition, we are applying the antibiotics. Applying the antibiotics means here it gone to the antibiotic stress. On that condition, it can able to survive, it enhance its resistance. So the bacterium enhance its resistance by increasing of number of plasmids. So adverse condition means antibiotic stress condition, high temperature condition, high metallic stress condition, the number of plasmids will increase. Okay, but basically you are seeing here single copy of plasmids, and some of the plasmids are, it means some of the bacteria are having more number of plasmids inside of it. Okay, so they are called as multiple copies of plasmids. So approximately the number 1 to 40. In adverse condition, can you know the number of plasmids reached up to 1000. So the plasmids are natural plasmids and derived plasmids, both are used in RDNA technology. So what is the ideal plasmid used in RDNA technology? What are the properties it have, it is suitable for RDNA technology means? So it shows some properties. It should have some properties. Plasmids. So the plasmid must have ORI region. What is ORI region? ORI region is origin of replication. So in the presence of origin of replication gene, so it able to multiply. So when the foreign DNA is integrated into the vector DNA, that is plasmid DNA, so the RDNA is produced. The RDNA also cloned in the presence of the ORI gene. So that's why the presence of ORI gene is compulsory in the plasmid. And so recognition sites are cloning sites. So cloning sites are, so what are cloning sites? Already I told different types of the restriction engines. They select the recognition sites on the DNA of particular organisms or vectors to make the cut. Okay, so here also, while in the incorporation of the foreign DNA,